patient. So that seems to prevent it from habituation. But when I talk about habituation, you're looking at about a year or so of administration.
Do you think in
the near
future antibody to be combined with
GcMAF? I think that probably is a must. Because right now, if you look at the antibiotics, pharmaceutical companies are no longer developing new antibiotics because we're developing resistance continuously. So nobody is interested in doing that. And there is another kind of direction which the world can go is bacteriophages. So I think Russia, Georgia, the countries that carry bacteriophages, but when I looked into bacteriophages, that's another world you don't even know what's going to happen if you're going to introduce that. So combination of GcMAF and combination of immunomodulators, and absolutely that's a must with antibiotics, because otherwise you don't see the results really when that's what happens. People come up to antibiotics, symptoms appear, they have, etc. You see what's happening in about 3 months, about 6 months, and very often we don't make that link, but if you observe, see exactly what happens in the immune system. Because in the study that they showed about the use of the chemo drug, what happens was driving from positive bacteria towards lymphocytes, stimulating lymphocytes, resetting the immune system. So if we're doing antibiotics, I think doing GcMAF, and that's a must. That's my opinion.
Yes, just one question. To consistently improve the immunity system in healthy bodies, would you suggest a small routine dosage can be administered to healthy people of GcMAF?
I don't think I understand the question, sorry.
To improve the immunity system of a healthy body, not specific to patients,
right.
Would you suggest that a small dosage of GcMAF can be administered to normal human individuals?
I don't see I don't see the problem with that, because as I said, we're all immunocompromised, and if you, as I mentioned earlier, if you had infections or if you're a physician and you're exposed to the infections all the time. So being asymptomatic doesn't mean that we don't have an infection. We don't know if human system cancels it or not. So would you feel more prone to kind of energy dropping down, you know, you're not feeling as good and all that, just enough would be an indication of something.
Alyssa?
Hello, Zoya. I just wanted to ask about using GcMAF with the herpes virus. How would you manage someone who's on antivirals?
I was able to get people on antivirals. It's nice. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, getting them off it, but do you take them off before start using GcMAF? Do you reduce the dosage over a period of time so that they don't get a flare-up through coming off the antivirals?
Usually what happens is when people get antivirals, GcMAF administration may be required, not daily, but maybe every second, third day. So I do that sometimes with UVB, ultraviolet irradiation, but GcMAF and so on, I think, can be used. And if you do frequent administration, see, you know, it kind of wins you off the antivirals and, you know, feeling good. And then if you feel something coming up, just even a little bit of a tint, just a hint that something is happening. So you start with something, you can give yourself another dose.
So what sort of dose would you use?
0.25. And I usually go close to the site. So if this is, for example, this is simplex, then it's very easy. You can just go into the posterior doctor with. But if you're dealing with a genital herpes, I just go closer to the site, you know, closer to the buttocks, and lesions are resolved in a day.
So if you've got somebody with herpes near the base of their spine, you could go into the buttocks?
I'm not even thinking that they have both low buttocks to where the lesion is.
Okay, thank you.
Autoimmune inflammatory disorders like dermatomyositis and lupus. Have you had experience with the?
I've done rheumatoid arthritis. I haven't done lupus. I've done it. I'm sure that if lupus, first of all, I've been able to clear lupus without pretty much without anything prior to my knowledge of GcMAF. So lupus is fairly straightforward to treat. So diet plays a huge role. You can actually regulate things very, very nicely. Unless arthritis, usually with something like 25 years of that. And I've dealt with rheumatoid arthritis with a person over 25 years of the disease and progression with significant just deformities. So what you need to do, you need to regulate the diet, that's number one. Gluten, dairy, sugar is number one, absolutely, because that's what we're dealing with. As I explained to my patients, when I'm saying to them, people have to be staying away from sugar for one simple reason. Because, as I said, it's a continuous battle with microflora, macroflora, what's going on with us. So we naturally do not really require sugar. If you look at the Eskimos, right, they live on meat. They don't have any sugar exposure whatsoever. So we make ketones, we have a way of dealing with sugar. However, microorganisms require sugar for their survival. So when we take sugar in, we actually help them feed the other population that lives in us. So if you regulate that part, if you regulate infections, so you can, if you still, because what happens very often, when you have an infection, and that infection is not cleared, it goes into the joints, right? It goes into connective tissue, and goes into thyroid, and you develop autoimmune disease. So the body's trying to attack, as was mentioned earlier, to attack the bug, but at the same time, it attacks the tissue. So it is an autoimmune disease. So you're still dealing with a bug, and at this point, it's a dysregulation of the immunity. So if you clear up the, feeding the infection, if you clear up the diet, so then you can bring inflammation down by using curcumin. I've done beautiful job with high-dose curcumin. But at the same time, you can support immune system, because by doing high-dose curcumin, you actually bring a lot of nuclear factor kappa B down, and interleukins that come from it, and complements that come from it, that all goes down. So that's good for regulation of the attack, in a sense, on the tissue. But on the other hand, you're also setting quite up for possible infections. So in that particular case, using GcMAF in combination with that could work very well.
Thank you.
Okay, I think we'll break for lunch. Thank you very much. I should point out that lunch is on the first floor.